This video is for educational purpose only. Assalamu alaikum. So in today's video, we are going to be discussing about monobactams. So monobactams are chemotherapeutic drugs, which can be used in different type of medical disorders. So let's discuss these drugs. First of all, monobactams are drugs which are having monocyclic β-lactam ring. So if we talk about their structure, they have only one β-lactam ring. Like over here, you can see three carbons and one nitrogen atom are being attached together to form a ring-like structure. And this is called as β-lactam ring. And if we talk about their spectrum, their spectrum of activity is limited to aerobic gram-negative organism, including P. aeruginosa. Unlike other beta-lactam antibiotics, they have no activity against gram-positive bacteria or anaerobes. So they are only effective against gram-negative bacteria. As we know, gram-negative bacteria have outer membrane, and they also have peptidoglycan, but peptidoglycan is much less quantity than that of in gram-positive bacteria. So these drugs are only effective against these kind of bacteria. And they are only effective against aerobic kind of organisms. So the drug that is available in USA, which is categorized under monobactam antibiotics, is Aztreonam. So Aztreonam is the only monobactam available in the USA. It has structural similarities to ceftazidime, and it is third generation cephalosporin antibiotic, and its gram negative spectrum is similar to that of third generation cephalosporin. So this drug actually has negative spectrum, gram-negative spectrum, which is similar to those of third-generation cephalosporin. And it has structural similarities with ceftazidime. So this is all about its spectrum. Next, as we know, there are many beta-lactamase enzymes. Those are enzymes which are being released by organism itself against the antibiotic which we human take against those organisms. So those organisms actually defend themselves with these enzymes. And what these enzymes do is that they destroy the beta-lactam ring of the antibiotic, which we have discussed previously in the structure of the antibiotic. So what actually happened that these beta-lactamase enzymes actually destroy their ring, and ultimately the destruction of the structure of the antibiotic lead to ineffectiveness of antibiotic in the human body, and antibiotic would no longer show its effect. So as we know, there are many types of or many kinds of beta-lactamases being released by different organisms. So this type of antibiotic that is Aztreonam, that is monobactam antibiotic. So monobactam antibiotics are stable against beta-lactamases. But there are some beta-lactamases which are exceptional, and they can destroy the ring of beta-lactam antibiotics. So these enzymes are AmpC β-lactamases and extended spectrum β-lactamases. So these kind of β-lactamases can destroy the beta-lactam ring of monobactam antibiotics as well. And next we have is that it can penetrate into the cerebrospinal fluid, which means that this drug can go into go into or can penetrate through blood-brain barrier. So it can be used against CNS disorders. So now if we talk about the dosage of Aztreonam. So Aztreonam is given intravenously every 8 hours in a dose of 1 to 2 grams, providing peak serum levels of 100 microgram per ml. So if you provide a patient 1 to 2 grams every 8 hours, so he or she will have a sustained peak serum level of 100 microgram per ml. So there will be 100 microgram of the drug in 1 ml of the serum. So now if we talk about the half-life of this drug. This drug has half-life of 1 to 2 hours and is greatly prolonged in renal failure. Obviously, if a patient is not functioning well renally, so there will be prolonged half-life of this drug. And there are patients which are allergic to penicillin drugs or its derivative. In those patients, we can use Aztreonam because it can affect well in those patients without showing any reaction. Notably, because of its structure similarity to ceftazidime, there is potential for cross-reactivity. So as we have discussed previously that it has some structural similarity with this drug. So what can happen that if a patient is allergic to ceftazidime, he may also have some kind of allergic reaction to Aztreonam because of structural similarities of Aztreonam with ceftazidime. So this can happen. Occasional skin rashes and elevation of serum aminotransferases occur during administration of Aztreonam. So skin rashes can occur and our serum have some aminotransferases which have the responsibility to transfer amino acid in different reactions. So such enzymes can elevate because of this drug. Major toxicity is uncommon. In patients with a history of penicillin anaphylaxis, Aztreonam may be used to treat serious infections such as pneumonia, meningitis, sepsis caused by susceptible gram-negative pathogens. So as we have discussed previously that penicillin allergic patients can also use this drug because it is well tolerated in them. So first of all, we can use this drug because of that reason. And secondly, as we know, this drug can cross blood-brain barrier. So it can be used in problems like meningitis. So we can use it in that case. But we have to keep that in mind that whatever problem we are treating is could be caused by gram-negative pathogens because it is only effective against gram-negative pathogens. It is not going to be showing any effectiveness against gram-positive or anaerobic organisms. So this is all about it. Thank you for watching and do subscribe to my channel.